Okay, here's the idea for today's photo. I'm a sucker for a landscape that has a little brook or creek running through it. So what I'm gonna do though, is I'm gonna kinda make this more furry and grassy, and I'm gonna put some flowers there. It's basically half the painting is light blue, half the painting is green, and you've got it broken up by these trees here. And I really like this blue in the background here, and so I'm gonna really work to preserve that blue. I like the green, but this is just too much green here. So we're gonna put some yellow flowers in here. I think that'll help make a nicer composition. And you'll have three regions. You'll have a blue stripe, a green stripe, and a yellow area with lots of darks in it. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do today. Keep that road in there a little bit. And well, let's get started. All right, I'll talk you through the painting a little bit. Here's the initial drawing. And you can see in the road there, the little tracks on that road, that it goes over a couple hills. I lost that in the painting process. So here we go with the initial wash. This blue is cobalt blue with a slight bit of burnt sienna just to tone it back a bit. The initial wash always dries really bright, almost white, which is what I wanted for this painting. Now here's that blue I like. And again, this is just a richer saturation of the sky color. Cobalt blue with a little burnt sienna in it. The only colors I used in here were burnt sienna, cad yellow medium, cobalt blue, and I brought in a little bit of cadmium red here and there, but for the most part, those are the only colors I used in this painting. You'll have to forgive me, my studio's in my garage, the fan is on and it's hot. So here I'm just laying in some colors, all these greens and yellows, and again, attempting to keep some of those hilly areas around that road by suggesting darker shadows, but it didn't really work out. A little more density in the background there. I've been using this new squirrel brush. It's a 1-inch flat squirrel brush, and I really like it. And I did the majority of the painting of the first and second washes with this squirrel brush. So yeah, I really like it. Going in with more darks here in the foreground and just basically setting up some dark tones so that when I come back with flowers over the top, I'll have a nice contrast there. There's some trees back there, so we're putting in kind of the shadowy base of the trees. Here's the main two trees, more shadowy base. Again, this is just cobalt blue with burnt sienna and yellow. Here's the banks of the creek. Cut those in. We're going to come in and put some reflections in there. Again, here I'm working the road, and I should have probably had these colors already down, but it worked out. All right, so we're just putting some darks in here, and that was another attempt to replicate the road, but my road tracks didn't really line up the way I had hoped they would. I didn't follow my drawing really well, so I just flattened the road out in the end. So just some tones in the road. Reflections in the water. The water needs to be pretty bright though. That's a kind of an overcast sky, and so water tends to reflect bright white. We'll put some reflections later from the bank and from the trees in the background in that water as well. You always want to be mindful of your reflections. Those trees may be in the background, but they're still going to reflect on that water. So here I go with some more darks. And I'm preserving some of that yellow, that little yellow stripe right there in the foreground to kind of be a clump of flowers. But I went in and put in those darks with my flat brush. Here I come in with my scraggly brush and have been softening up some of the edges. But I really want this grass to be kind of furry because, you know, overgrown and grassy, so that it has flowers in there and you can reasonably expect that you might walk through there and get some ticks or something. Again, more darks in the foreground. You want as much dark. You want to bring your darks into the foreground, more dark than you think. And what that'll do is help to give depth to your painting. That contrast of the dark in the foreground, really dark and saturated colors in the foreground, playing against the lighter colors in the background, the less saturation, and the more cooler colors in the background, give you that really that impression of depth. And that's what you really get from warm colors up front and cool colors in the back. There's a bank reflection there. We'll work on that a little more shortly as well.
But yeah, you really want to watch out for your darks in the background. They shouldn't be too dark. Like that line I just put there on the bank of that creek, it's a little too straight, a little too dark. And at this point, I'm hoping it'll dry a little bit more light, as watercolor tends to do. I could go lift it out, but I'd risk getting some stain in that water that shouldn't be there. So here we are, just putting some more warm color in that roadbed, straightening it out. I decided, you know, there's no hill there. That's the beauty of painting, is you can kind of make things up as you go. And here we go, cutting into these trees. And I'm just using a brush to put in some scrubby branches there. And that'll help out to give the impression that it's one of these kind of bushy trees. And then I'll go in with my liner brush and put in more of the main trunks and branches. But we put that in. Now we start with the foliage. I wanted this tree to be kind of open, not a real dense tree. It's a scrubby, bushy tree. But the thing about foliage, watch these two trees in the background here when I put that in. You want to paint shapes. We're not painting every leaf, and we're not trying to go in with a fan brush. We're painting shapes. Like, those are just shapes, and they suggest trees. Those two trees in the background are virtually done. I'll come back and put some color in there. But on these two foreground trees, we're also just painting shapes. We're painting clumps of green to suggest, you know, areas of foliage. So you're not painting every leaf. You're coming in and just putting in a suggestion. My camera ran out of memory. I had not deleted my other painting, so you missed the flowers. Got to put some birds in. Birds give an impression of depth and space. I like to put birds in. I love birds. Just some more contrast and some more darks. So yeah, I went in with some gouache and some cad yellow to make those flowers and just dotted them in. You could go in there and splash them in and you know, do the old watercolor trick, but I went in and did them one by one. It just gives me a little more control. Just a little white gouache, and that's the painting. So this painting is kind of the typical landscape look that I enjoy, and I really enjoyed this painting. There was a time when that road made me think I was going to botch this one. The creek's a little straight back there, but you know, hey, that's the way painting is. So there it is. Thank you for watching this video. I'm grateful. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and like our video, comment, and share it, and we'll talk to you next time. Take care.